According to reports, the impact was not only on individuals, but also the wider economy, wiping $750 billion off the value of the global cultural and creative industries. This means that most youths who had established a stake in the sector lost their investments and will need refueling to get going again. This probably explains the time unveiling of the Cottage Industry Catapult Program. The program seeks to train and provide access to raw materials for 200 MSMEs, give 100 businesses access to trained labor, and 50 MSMEs access to finance.
And like I said, we acknowledge the whole country was first was challenged by COVID, but currently for us, we are currently focused in Central and in the West Nile region. We do understand the challenges and disadvantages that that comes with, but it is something that we are also taking into consideration and having a conversation around. So how big is the kit that we are working with? Particularly in this grant, the kit we are working with is 190 million. We are looking to give out 190 million. And like Carol said, we have kits that are starting from 10 million, or we could even go beyond and say like 20 million, because you're looking at, if you're giving 20 million, it could mean lesser people. If you're giving 10 million, it could mean more people. But our average is 190 million, and the team at Innovation Village will be able to give us a breakdown in terms of how many people will receive that money and what will be given to them.
This is being done under the COVID-19 Response Initiatives for Eastern Africa, aimed at reducing the impact caused by the pandemic on businesses and strengthen the entrepreneurial capacity of the young people in the country.
Be in contact with the Aga Khan Foundation, and alongside the Aga Khan Foundation, we thought it appropriate and necessary for us to work together in order to expedite the kind of work that we are doing within the creative and cultural industries. A lot of people talk about the creative economy, but nobody knows specifically what we mean by creative economy, if we can all agree. So this morning, we'll be sharing just a little bit about what we mean by creative economy through the program that we are delivering with the Aga Khan Foundation, which of course, I'll say once again, we have the privilege and honor to do so. And we'll also be sharing a lot of the things that we'll be looking out for, especially as we go into the next couple of months, where we'll be making available incubation services, as well as enabling and empowering young entrepreneurs who qualify for this program to be able to win up to 10 million Uganda shillings.
Some of the challenges that we faced along the way was access to income and to enable us scale, you know. You need inventory, you need to build a team, you need to pay the team. And us getting to know there's an opportunity for Aga Khan to step in and enable our businesses to scale, provide the funding that we need, is a huge relief on our end, honestly. That means we have more time to focus on producing products, focus on making sure that our quality is good, and get as many young people on board, as many women employed, because their goal is to create several jobs across the value chain, which is also fitting into our vision as a brand.
According to Caro Kagezi, the community lead at Motive, the program is a great opportunity for a fresh start for businesses in the creative sector. The program is expected to run for 2 months, and up to 190 million shillings will be given to youths in the creative industry operating within the Central and West Nile regions.